John, it is great to see you. You look amazing.
Thank you. I've been working hard on it, very hard.
Have you? Wow. Have you? How much have you lost?
I've lost 25 pounds, U.S. pounds.
Wow.
But all to do with tennis and weightlifting and diet. So I've been working hard. I was doing it for myself at first, and then I got a part in a movie that asked for me to be a little svelte. So I decided to go for it. It's a lot of hard work, you know.
Well done you. Although with the tennis and stuff, you sound like you've had a little bit of fun. And yeah. I did see you dancing with your good friend Kirstie Alley at one stage.
Oh, yes, yes. Well, you know, all that's good. That'll all do it.
Fantastic. And is that the Robert De Niro role?
Yes,
the movie?
Yes, yes.
What is that?
Oh, that film is just about two ex-military guys who are after each other. But it's kind of a message about war and the truth of what war is and, you know, that what does it mean at the end of the day. And it's kind of a good thing, a good message about, you know, we could do without it, you know, but it's a very interesting scenario and how they get to find out about each other.
Brilliant.
So two character piece.
I'm looking forward to seeing you two on the screen together. I think that'll be really good. But we always look forward to having you here.
Thank you.
And what's brought you by? What's brought you to Australia this time?
You know, Qantas has its 91st birthday. Yeah. They have the introduction of the Platinum One service, which is all the special passengers that have earned a new level of achievement as a passenger, which a lot of the services are kind of secret that I don't even know the specialties, but the upgrades and the concierge style of service. So they're pretty excited about it, the passengers. And then we have the 787 Dreamliner coming out, which offers a whole new style of travel with a bigger window and the humidity set and the lower altitude in the cabin, so less jet lag and all the creature comforts that are, you know, just progressing to make travel easier for everyone.
Have you flown in one of those, or will you be able to, are you qualified to fly one of those?
Well, each plane you have to get a new license. So I did get to fly the A380 as a test pilot. So we'll see what happens with the 787.
And you, of course, brought your plane as usual this time.
I did. My plane's an icon. You know, this whole homage to Qantas vis-a-vis history.
Indeed.
That I have, and I adore it, you know.
However, a little spy spied it with some different paint on it for a TV show in the not-too-distant past.
That? Yes, I asked permission from my boss, Qantas, if I could loan it to the Pan Am show, and they borrowed it for a few days, and they painted it up in Pan Am colors.
Wow.
And it starred last week. I still have to see it because I was flying here when it was aired, so we'll see how it goes.
But it's back to Qantas colors now.
Back to Qantas colors, absolutely.
That would have felt so wrong to see you here in that way.
Absolutely.
How is fatherhood? How's the new boy? How old is he now, and how's Kelly?
Next week, he is a year old.
Wow.
So I'll get home just in time for his birthday. Kelly's doing terrific, and Ella's doing terrific. But the one who's doing best is Ben. He's just walking now.
Wow.
And eating solid foods and saying lots of different words. And he's just adorable. So we're very happy.
That is wonderful news because I remember I was talking to you a year ago and you were just waiting for the phone call to have to go.
I remember that.
We're standing in front of the A380 at the 90th birthday party.
That's right. That's right.
What is it you love about Qantas? You've stayed loyal. You know, it's no secret the last few weeks haven't been the easiest time for these guys. And, you know, what do you say to them when you come here?
Well, I'm just, you know, look, you guys have it a lot better here than we do in the States as far as when there are those kinds of issues. We don't have that arbitration situation. You do. So when things can't get met, the government comes in and settles it, and everybody feels a little better because it's an outside party. So I'm thrilled for how it's going and where it will go. I think it'll be fine.
And you ought to have this party tonight with so many things moving forward, new plane, new frequent flyer system.
Exactly.
And you do like coming to a party here, don't you?
Sure, absolutely. That's my...
Now, your president is, of course, in town as well. Is that just a coincidence?
Yes, and apparently we're competing with him tonight for a company, but we did pretty well, I think.
Yeah, you've pulled about 800, I think. I don't know. Don't know how many he got.
I don't either, but maybe we should keep it a secret.
Maybe we should. And the other great thing you did just a few days ago, which shows how much you've been zipping around the world, is you were with your very dear friend and Australia's very dear friend, Oprah. She got an Oscar. What was it like being there that night?
Well, you know, here's a girl that refers to herself as a girl born in 1954 that shouldn't, by all reasons, achieve this. So her perspective on getting an Oscar is so dramatic that it was really beautiful to see her response to this award, because it was a dream, an impossible dream come true. So to be part of that and to give her an homage and to be there seeing her, you know, her biggest moment was wonderful. Yeah. And justly deserved. And I even told her, beyond being a humanitarian, she's a damn good actress, and she deserves another Oscar for being an actor too, you know.
Yeah. You could do a role with her one day on that I'd film that. You keep promising to come and film in Australia.
Yeah, why don't we do that? Wouldn't that be amazing?
Yeah.
Well, she is great.
And you've all got the connection here. It'd be quite nice.
Yeah, it would be quite nice.
It'd be quite nice. Good, as always, to catch up with you. Thank you so much. I know it's another quick trip, but make the most of it while you're here.
I will. Bye.
Mwah. Thank you.
Thanks.